Welcome to the Prep Athletics Podcast. This is Corey Heights.
Some battles. I'm not sure if they got us. If they did, maybe.
So you will get better as a player during that year.
So it was kind of exciting. Like, oh yeah, somebody wants me.
I'm looking for humility, what we do is really hard. We want kids to be leaders. We want them to be academic. We want them to be basketball. We want it to be in that order. We want it to be very high level. And you have to have a level of humility about it. If you're filled with ego, it's going to be really, really hard to do it. So my brother is a professor of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and you know, before the bout, they bow. And I asked him, I was like, all right, obviously it's a sign of respect, but really what's that all about? He's like, you're emptying your cup of your ego and you're allowing, and your opponent is actually your teacher. And if you're paying attention, the person that you're competing against will fill your cup with information about yourself. Your actual opponent is your ego. So in basketball, if I do a pump fake and the defender doesn't respond, a kid who has his ego filled will say, why didn't that guy move? A kid who has the cup emptied of his ego will say, my pump fake isn't good enough. And there's a level of humility that happens in order for you to learn. And we're really looking for that. I say all the time, the two biggest killers for athletes are delusion and entitlement. And I'm constantly keeping my eyes out for kids who are truly delusional about their work ethic in relation to their talent and their entitlement as far as I want things rather than I've earned it, you know? So if we have a guy who wins, you know, is honored with any kind of award, we always say they earned player, you know, Atlantic, you know, Kellen Grady, he's earned Atlantic 10 Player of the Week. We never say he was given the Atlantic 10 Player of the Week. And we're very selective about that and careful about the words we use, because entitled kids think they deserve things and like without putting in the work. And kids who are filled with humility know that they've earned something and they have more to do. And the kids who, you know, so that's really what we're looking for is, you know, kids who are humble, ego, maybe not free, but ego accessible, and kids who are not delusional and not entitled. And those are tough things to avoid. Yeah.